What's up, investors? My name is Artem Tikarev. In a couple of minutes, you'll know what is accounts receivable turnover ratio. And if you want to learn personal finances and investing watching such short videos, please consider liking this video and subscribing to my channel so you won't lose it. I am Russian, so let's get straight to the point. Alright, so accounts receivable turnover ratio, or how some people call it receivables ratio, is the activity ratio that shows the effectiveness of a management of a company at collecting money from its clients. Some other activity ratios would be assets turnover ratio, inventory turnover ratio, and fixed assets turnover ratio. And if you're not sure what some of them mean, feel free to watch my other videos. And here is an example. The formula for accounts receivable turnover ratio is pretty simple. You just need to take net credit sales and divide it by average accounts receivable. Credit sales are basically these types of sales for which customers will be paying in parts, just like regular purchases that you do with your credit card. And the formula for net credit sales is total revenue from credit sales minus credit sales allowances and returns. While average accounts receivable is basically the accounts receivable at the beginning of the period plus accounts receivable at the end of the period divided by 2. Accounts receivable turnover ratio is basically showing how effective is the management of this company at collecting money that is owed to it by its customers. Let's say so, company's A net credit sales for 2020 were $1 million. Accounts receivable at the beginning of 2020 were $200,000 and at the end of 2020 became $300,000. Which means that the average accounts receivable is $200,000 plus $300,000 divided by 2, which equals $250,000. And now, let's plug these numbers into our formula. So, companies A accounts receivable turnover ratio is $1 million divided by $250,000, which equals 4. And it means that this company is able to collect all of its money that is owed to it by its customers approximately 4 times per year. You can even go further and take the total number of days in 1 year, which is obviously 365, and divide by accounts receivable turnover ratio, which is 4 in our case. So 365 divided by 4 equals approximately 91.25, which means that on average it takes approximately a little bit more than 91 days or 3 months for customers of company A to fully cover its obligations. Higher ratio suggests that the company is effective at collecting money from its customers, and also that these customers are more or less reliable and of a higher quality, which is always good for any kind of business. While low ratio means that there are delays in customer payments. And since company is not receiving its payments in time, it can potentially disrupt the whole business cycle. Always make sure to compare accounts receivable turnover ratio between companies from the same industry. And the reason for this it is because different industries might have different acceptable standards of financial health. Additionally, accounts receivable turnover ratio is just one of the ratios that investors use when analyzing a company. That is why you should never rely solely on it when making your final investment decision. Feel free to leave a comment if you have any questions left. Check my other videos to see if there is anything else interesting for you. Thank you so much, comrades.